When learning the for loop, many students find it very confusing. However, with this video, I will make it very easy for you to understand the concept of for loop in C programming. Wait till the end of this video. You will understand for loop and how to make practical use of for loop in a program. Let's get started. The for loop is used to repeat a particular set of statements multiple times. This loop is similar to the while loop and do while loop. However, the syntax of for loop is different and it reduces the complexity of the code. I will add the link in the description if you want to learn while and do while loop. Here is the syntax of for loop. Here, for is a keyword in C. Within round brackets, there are three parts separated by semicolons. These three parts are initialization, condition, and increment-decrement. The initialization part is used to initialize a variable. The condition part will be an expression that evaluates to true or false. The increment-decrement part is used to increase or decrease the value of initialized variable. The block of statements associated with the for loop needs to be enclosed within curly braces. This is how the for loop works. The program will first perform the initialization when it encounters the for keyword. The initialization is where the variable can be declared and given an initial value, for example, int count equals to 0. Once the initialization part is done, the program will evaluate the condition part. The condition can evaluate to true or false. If the condition evaluates to false, the program will not execute the block of statements enclosed within curly braces. And if the condition evaluates to true, the block of statements enclosed within curly braces will be executed. Once done, the program will perform the increment-decrement part. The increment-decrement part is used to increment or decrement the value of variable initialized in the initialization part. Once the increment or decrement is performed, the program will evaluate the condition again. And if the condition evaluates to true, the block of statements enclosed within curly braces will be executed again. The program will again perform increment-decrement operation. Once done, it will evaluate the condition. And if the condition evaluates to true again, the program will execute the block of statements enclosed within curly braces. It then again performs increment-decrement operation followed by condition evaluation. This process is repeated as long as the condition evaluates to true. And if the condition evaluates to false, the program will skip the block of statements enclosed within curly braces and the control will be transferred to the line of code immediately after closing curly braces of the for loop. In this entire process, the initialization part is performed only once. Now, let's understand the for loop with the help of an example. If you are getting value from this video, please support me by clicking the like and subscribe button. Here is a program in C that uses the for loop. This for loop has three parts separated by semicolon. Int I equals to 0, which is an initialization part. Here, we are declaring an initializing value 0 to int variable I. I less than 2 is a condition part. I less than 2 is an expression that can evaluate to true or false. The third part, I plus is an increment decrement part. Here, I am incrementing the value of I by 1. I plus is same as I equals to I plus 1. And within curly braces, I have a printf statement that will display the value of I. During the execution, when the program encounters the for keyword, it will first perform the initialization part. It will declare and initialize the variable I to 0. Once done, the condition will be evaluated. I less than 2, that is 0 less than 2. This condition evaluates to true. Hence, the program will execute this printf statement enclosed within curly braces and display the value of I, which is 0. It will then perform the increment-decrement part, I++. The value of I will be incremented by 1. The new value of I will be set to 1. The program will then evaluate this condition again, I less than 2, that is 1 less than 2, which evaluates to true. Since this condition evaluates to true, the program will execute this printf statement again and display the value of I, that is 1. It will then perform the increment-decrement part again, I++. The value of I will be incremented by 1. The new value of I will be set to 2. The program will then evaluate this condition again, I less than 2, that is 2 less than 2. 2 less than 2 evaluates to false. Hence, the program will skip the printf statement inside the curly braces and exit the for loop. The control will be transferred to the line of code immediately after closing curly braces. The program will execute return 0 and exit the code execution. I will run the program. If you see here, This program displayed 0 and 1 on the output screen, which is as expected. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section of this video. I will make sure to reply to your comments. Now that we have understood the working of for loop, let's write a simple program in C that will calculate the sum of whole numbers from 0 to 10, that is 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 until value 10. The program should use the for loop and print the value of sum on the output screen. I have created a new program file. I will first declare an int variable named sum and initialize it to value 0. This variable will store the sum of whole numbers from 0 to 10. Int sum equals to 0. In the next line, I will create an outline of the for loop. Let's fill it up. I want this for loop to repeat 11 times, that is from 0 to 10, including 0 and 10. We know that the for loop has 3 parts, initialization, condition, and increment decrement. I will first add the initialization part, int I equals to 0, followed by semicolon. I want this for loop to be repeated until the value of I is less than or equal to 10. Hence, I will add the condition, I less than or equal to 10, followed by semicolon. After each iteration, I want to increment the value of I by 1. I will add I++. This is how this for loop will execute. First, the program will initialize and declare int variable I to 0. It will then check this condition, I less than or equal to 10, that is 0 less than or equal to 10, which evaluates to true. Hence, the block of code enclosed within curly braces will be executed. I will add a statement here, sum equals to sum plus I, followed by semicolon. On execution of this statement, the new value of sum will be 0 plus 0, that is 0. There are no other statements inside the curly braces of for loop. Hence, the control will be transferred to the increment-decrement part. Here, I have I++. The value of I will be incremented by 1. The new value of I is set to 1. The program will then perform the condition check again. I less than or equal to 10, that is 1 less than or equal to 10, which evaluates to true. Since this condition evaluates to true, the control will be transferred to the line of code inside the curly braces of the for loop. Sum equals to sum plus I. This statement evaluates to sum equals to 0 plus 1, which is equal to 1. The new value of the sum is set to 1. The control will be transferred to the increment-decrement part again, that is I++ in this case. The value of I will be incremented by 1. The new value of I is now set to 2. The program will then perform this condition check again, I less than or equal to 10, that is 2 less than or equal to 10, which evaluates to true again. Since this condition evaluates to true, the control will be transferred to the line of code inside the curly braces of for loop. Sum equals to sum plus I, which evaluates to sum equals to 1 plus 2, which is equal to 3. The control is again transferred to the increment-decrement part. This loop is repeated until I less than or equal to 10 becomes false. That is, when the value of I becomes 11, the program will exit this for loop. By the end of this for loop, the value of sum will be 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 until 10, which is equal to 55. I will add a printf statement to print a value of sum which is currently holding the sum of whole numbers starting 0 until 10. I will go here outside of the for loop and type printf within double quotes. The value of sum is %d, sum, followed by semicolon. And in the next line, I will type return 0. I will run this program. If you see here, the program displayed the value of sum, which is the sum of whole numbers starting 0 until 10. If you want to download this code, I have added a link in the description of this video. Do you know the difference between compile time, runtime, and logical error in C? This is going to be a knowledge-filled and exciting video for you. Click here to watch it now. And if this video helped you, encourage me to create more videos like this by clicking on the like and subscribe button. Thank you.